Good morning. Today we are going to play a game I'm calling What Line Is That Anyway? A game where all the lines are made up and the points don't matter.
Flippin' physics.
So are we going to have to do improv? Cause,
No, it is just a fun, catchy title. We are actually going to do a Kahoot. Let's get that started. And while y'all are signing up, let me explain. So, recently, I got the opportunity to be an AP Physics reader for the first time. That means more than 800 other physics teachers and I spent 7 days in a row scoring student responses to AP Physics exam questions. It was a great experience. I actually had a fun time. I met some lovely people and I learned a lot. Today, I'm going to present to you hypothetical student responses to a hypothetical sketch a graph question on a hypothetical AP Physics exam. Any perceived similarities between the responses depicted herein and those that might be provided by actual students, whether real or hypothetical, living or otherwise, is entirely accidental, unintentional, and purely coincidental. No actual students were consulted, referenced, or harmed in the making of these answers, and any overlap with real student thought processes, however implausible or uncanny, is a delightful happenstance of fiction mirroring reality.
Makes sense to me.
Of course.
And here we go. The first question is, did the student sketch a horizontal line? This is not a horizontal line.
It looks horizontal to me.
Right. It could be.
Yeah, now, while I agree that the student might have tried to draw a horizontal line here, as a reader, I cannot make the assumption that that is what they were trying to do. So, class, what do I suggest every student bring to their AP Physics exam which would help in this situation?
A ruler with a straight edge.
But don't all rulers have straight edges?
You clearly have never seen my ruler.
Okay.
Exactly. Please bring a ruler with a straight edge. And if you need to draw a horizontal line, measure vertically upward from the horizontal axis, draw two dots which are equidistant from the horizontal axis, and then connect the two dots using the ruler.
Right. We actually have to use the ruler.
With a straight edge.
Actually, I use a transparent ruler.
Why?
It makes it easier to see all the data points when I'm drawing my best fit line.
Oh, that makes sense.
Yeah.
Wow, that is a good idea, Bobby. Thanks. And looks like Billy is in the lead. Next question. Again, did the student sketch a horizontal line?
Yeah.
Correct. This student clearly brought and used a ruler with a straight edge to sketch this line.
I thought you said these were not real student responses.
Right, they are not. It is just easier to pretend that they are.
Sure.
And Billy is still in the lead. The next question, again, did the student sketch a horizontal line? Bobby, you are correct.
But the student wrote horizontal, right? So they indicated it would be a horizontal line.
Yeah, how is that wrong?
But did they sketch a horizontal line?
Oh.
Exactly. You have to follow the instructions. If you are asked to sketch a line, you have to sketch something. You will not receive points if you do not sketch a line.
That seems kind of unfair. I mean, they wrote a correct answer, right?
Yeah, I know it may seem a bit harsh. However, the readers have to draw a line somewhere.
Nice.
And following the basic instructions is required to gain points.
Okay, that makes sense, I guess.
Yeah,
sure.
And Billy is still in the lead. The next question still is, did the student sketch a horizontal line? Yes, everybody got it correct. The point here is that if you are terrible at sketching, you can identify what you tried to sketch by adding words like horizontal to indicate you were trying to draw a horizontal line. And Bobby has taken the lead.
I was faster.
Oh, right.
And the next question, again, still is, did the student sketch a horizontal line? Right. Unfortunately, no. This student did not sketch a horizontal line.
Yes, they did. It's right there. They just crossed it off.
If you cross something off, the graders cannot grade it.
Exactly. However, the College Board does call us readers and not graders.
Sure.
Yeah, I cannot tell you how many times I was unable to grade a correct solution just because a student crossed it out. So please, be careful crossing stuff out on the AP exam. And Bobby is still in the lead.
Yep.
The next question, again, still is, did the student sketch a horizontal line?
Yep.
Again, correct. There will be times when you feel like you do need to cross something off. And if you need to, you can cross off the entire graph, which you do not want graded, create a new graph, and sketch your answer there. Just be very clear about what you want graded. And while Bobby is in the lead, Bo is evidently on fire.
Yeah.
And the next question still is, for the last time, did the student sketch a horizontal line? No.
But they did sketch a horizontal line.
They even used a straight edge.
Yeah.
Right. However, they drew their answer outside the provided graph. I can almost guarantee you that if there is no space provided below the horizontal axis on a graph, the correct answer will not be drawn below the horizontal axis.
Oh, so if the vertical axis extends below the horizontal axis, the correct answer will be drawn below the horizontal axis. Got it. Thanks.
Actually, no, that is not what I said. I said, if there is no space provided below the horizontal axis on a graph, the correct answer will not be drawn below the horizontal axis.
Oh, so if the vertical axis extends below the horizontal axis, the correct answer might be something drawn below the horizontal axis. However, if the vertical axis does not extend below the horizontal axis, the correct answer will not be below the horizontal axis.
Correct. In other words, do not add space to a graph which was not originally provided.
But they did draw a horizontal line, so the answer to this question should be yes, right?
Okay, sure. They did draw a horizontal line. However, I am more concerned about helping you get correct answers on the AP Physics exam. So, if you find yourself wanting to sketch something outside the space of the graph provided on the exam, go back and reread the question to see if you missed something. For example, in this problem, you might be trying to draw a constant negative velocity. However, the question may have asked for the magnitude of the velocity, and the magnitude of a quantity is always positive. Right?
Oh, right.
Right. And now a word from our sponsor.
This quiz is proudly brought to you by the AP Physics 1 Ultimate Exam Slayer, your one-stop powerhouse for crushing the AP Physics 1 exam. Packed with in-depth videos on all four types of free response questions, detailed breakdowns of every category of multiple choice, and battle-tested test-taking strategies just like the ones you see in this very video. But wait, there's more. You'll get not one, but two full-length practice exams, each powered by our AP Exam Simulator, carefully crafted to mirror the real digital AP exam experience. This simulator is not created or endorsed by the College Board or Blue Book. It's just made to help you dominate the exam. And now, back to our host with the most, Mr. P.
Yeah, okay. So the scores are still the same. And the next question is, did the student sketch a curved line? Right, so the answer here really is I don't know. As a reader, we spend so much time looking at lines and trying to decide if the line is straight or curved. Please use a straight edge for straight lines and draw curves that are clear, that clearly look like curves. Do not try to hedge your bets and draw something that looks like it could be either. Just commit to a straight line or a curve and make it clear. If you make it ambiguous like this, you are actually more likely to not gain the point. And the ranks are still the same. And the next question again is, did the student sketch a curved line?
Yes.
Yes, clearly a curved line. Please draw your curved lines like this. And it looks like Beau was a bit faster that time.
Nice.
Thanks.
And the next question again is, did the student sketch a curved line? Right. The student cannot gain a point for this because they have two different answers, and they did not cross off the one that they do not want graded.
But they wrote, grade the red line, right?
And which line is red?
The one they drew in red.
And which one is that?
I don't know.
Right.
Exactly. Please realize every scan I saw of student solutions was in black and white. So do not use different colored pens. Please. And it looks like Beau is still in the lead. Okay, now a new question. Did the student sketch a velocity of zero?
Yep, nice.
No, they did not. Again, you have to sketch your answer, even if that answer is zero. This is why the axes on the answer graphs on the AP exams are dashed lines, to make it so the reader can better see when you have drawn a horizontal line with a value of zero. And now Bobby is in the lead.
Well done.
Thanks.
Next question. Again, did the student sketch a velocity of zero? Right. Again, if you do not sketch something, you cannot receive points when the instructions are to sketch something. And Bobby is still in the lead. Next question again. Did the student sketch a velocity of zero? This is how you sketch a constant velocity of zero. You draw a line over the horizontal axis. And Bobby is still in the lead. And now on fire.
Yep.
Now the penultimate question. Are you going to bring a ruler with a straight edge to your AP Physics exam? Of course you are, and maybe even a transparent one. And Beau took the lead.
Yep.
And now the last question. Are the sketching answers just as important as multiple step derivations on the AP Physics exams? Yes. Absolutely no question about it. Please realize that while sketches may seem relatively unimportant because they are just drawings, your sketches are definitely important and can be worth as many points as a multiple step derivation.
Hey, Bo, you look just like Mr. P when he was 17 years old. That's pretty cool.
Sure.
Yeah, that's weird. Why do you think?
I don't know.
Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoy learning with you.
Mr. P, can we see who won, please?
Oh, yeah, sorry, sure.
Congratulations, Bobby. You won.
Yep.
Thanks.